Yo, what's going on YouTube? And today we're going to be talking about why I believe that the new Cold War Zombies map, DIE Machine, is the best map on Call of Duty Zombies of all time. Now, that's not to say it's my favourite map, it's absolutely not. I'd say Der Isendrak or Revelations are my favourite maps. Unpopular opinion, but I think this is the best map that's been made. Now, I'll talk to you a bit about why. So, to start off, it's brilliant for new players. It's really simple to check out. It's not difficult. It can be difficult.
Maybe there's some sort of archaic sensor-based door system.
For new players, which we've seen a lot of so far on the zombies community, it's a good way to introduce them to zombies rather than having all the storylines from previous games. They've not really been able to catch up.
I'm not sure.
I do like the storyline. I think it's a good idea.
It started off well.
The only thing I would say
we should really get the power on before we make any assumptions.
But what can you do? I do like the story. It's honestly, it's new, it's fresh, so I loved the storyline. It was brilliant, it was done really well. But I feel like it was time for a change, and honestly, we're due it, so I'm excited to see what this goes and how it progresses. The map as well, it's unique, so obviously it's got seven points, which was the first ever zombies map. Don't mind me doing it just yet, big noob. So yeah, to get back to the top minute. It's technically a remaster.
Right now,
I feel
we need
like
to figure out why Omega reactivated.
A small part of the gameplay. But it doesn't feel like a remaster, it feels like an entirely new map with a little bit of familiarity for old zombies players. The new ideas and gameplay in this map is honestly brilliant as well. I've got the new health system, so it used to be, without jug, first of all it was 2 hits, and then you'd down without jug on the original zombies games, and then it was 3 hits with jug. And then it was 3 hits without jug, and then 4 hits with jug, but now it's a health system and an armor-based system, which I prefer. I think it attracts the Warzone players as well, who will probably prefer that overall because it's what they're used to. Again, I think it makes maybe a little bit of an easier challenge for sort of experienced players in zombies, but I don't think it's necessarily a bad thing because, you know, higher ups and, you know, Easter egg rooms are a little bit easier and less time consuming, so instead of having to spend, you know, 8-9 hours on around 100 attempts, you're maybe 4-5-6, which is less than good because, you know, it's not easier, but I feel it's all round better. The movement system as well, you're able to climb over everything, the sprinting feels a lot better. Movement just feels a lot more fluid and easy to sort of pick up on. The jumping over things, you can pretty much jump over anything, it's pretty good. And yeah, so if we continue talking about the gameplay, the weapon upgrade system, as you can see, I'm using pack punch just now. Sadly not enough points to pack a punch. But I think it's honestly a really good idea. It lets you almost use any weapon you want without it being too difficult. Games don't want weapons that were bad, and there were weapons that you just couldn't use, which to an extent is it'd be very difficult to use people.
It's the bridge to the other dimension.
Weapons, it makes it,
you know, the one currently spilling into our own reality.
So your sniper could do like 4 times the damage, which already means that you can start upgrade it to like faster fire, add custom attachments and things like that. Which makes it, again, across the playing field more balanced in terms of what weapons you want to use, you can use. Unless you're going for higher rounds, in which case you'll need the window weapon and the ray gun, but if you're complaining about that, you shouldn't really be going for higher rounds. Again, continuing on from set up, but it's really easy to set up. When you start with a gun, you can upgrade your gun when you start with it. You can make it better, which is really good. Instead of having to start with a pistol, which you don't get more difficult for some people. can start with whatever weapon you want, and upgrade it to how you want it to be, and then continue to upgrade it in the game, so you don't need to spend any points on weapons in the game if you want to. While we're talking about classes, the field upgrades, they're brilliant. Again, you can use any of them, really. I'd say the frost, what it's called, pyrophos or something, and the ether shroud are probably the best in my opinion. But again, people will disagree, and that's fine because you can use any of them. There isn't a definitive best. I really like the equipment drops as well. They're handy instead of having to spawn with 5 grenades and grenades we all know do nothing. You can choose what you get, you can buy them with the
ready to go.
Salvage is a really good idea. And perks as well. The same but different. So you've got your jug, your stamina, your people, and your quick revive, which are, you know, staples of Black Ops zombies. A jug does the same, except you can upgrade all the perks. So through your choice, obviously. And Deadshot as well, I forgot the Deadshot. You can obviously upgrade and they do better things. So for example, I can't really remember, but Jug puts you up to 250 health if you fully upgrade it. And then with the armor as well, you're
a radioactive specimen is moving towards you. Radiation levels are through the roof.
Get used to and more fun.
Practically a warning shot.
And yeah, so you've got speed cola. Stamina feels a lot better than it used to. It just maybe it's because it feels like you can move around a lot more. As it were, there's me using Ether Shroud, it's pretty good. It basically teleports you forward and acts as a zombie blitz, and it's invisible to 8 seconds for it. Yeah, the new boss is really like, it's not too much of a challenge, but it's difficult to wear.
So, the creature is still alive, it's difficult. It's just,
it takes a while.
Well, there's
no one
now. Also, you made it even more pissed off.
I don't mind me, and yeah, last thing I'm going to talk about is much I really like. Again, going back to the new players, I feel like, and even for in the zombies community, I feel like, you know, round 100 runs, you get to round 100 and you have to die, and you just feel like it's not really I'm about to die here. But if now, you know, you can easily exfil on round 100 and then you've completed it, it's almost like more of a completion. And yeah, it's a really good idea, especially for new players, so they can get to round 15, round 20, wherever they feel like they can, and then they can exfil and feel like they've completed something, and the more XP so yeah, I really appreciate you guys watching and your opinions down in the comments below. I definitely believe whilst not who's played it and can play it. So yeah, I really appreciate you guys watching. I'll see you next time. Peace.